My mom made me come here. I went to Harper Valley, this really far away elementary school, and not five people here came. I had never heard of Harper Hall. Everyone was like, you're going to an all-girls school, that's so weird. So I didn't want to come here, but after a year at Harper Hall, I'm obviously glad I did.
What are a few words you use to describe yourself?
Outgoing. Trying to be funny sometimes, but maybe sometimes not successfully. Carefree, lighthearted.
Where is like your favorite place in the whole world? Anywhere that you've been that you love?
I'm gonna be a brat and say Africa because I went to Kenya during winter. It was awesome. I haven't been. That's like the only time I've been out of the country, but just traveling in general, I love travel. And also, I'm gonna have to say my grandparents' farm, because I've been going there since I was little and I just spent so much time there. So I live there as well.
What's your favorite song?
A lot of Beyonce songs. Been obsessed with her since fifth grade. It was sort of a problem with it, but now it's really accepted. Wouldn't It Be Nice, Beach Boys. It's a good song. It's one of my favorites.
What are your favorite movies, books, TV shows, foods, colors?
Favorite movies, Never Been Kissed with Drew Barrymore. Obsessed with her. What's Up Doc with Barbara Streisand. It's old, but it's still really funny. And all Pixar movies. I'm sort of a goo, but that's just how it is. I prefer movies over TV shows, so there's a lot of them, but yeah. Those are just
books.
This is cliche, but I love To Kill a Mockingbird.
That's a great book. Foods?
I eat a lot, so I have like a lot of chocolate and candy every morning, which probably isn't good, but major sweet tooth, so anything sweet. And pizza's always a good thing. Southern food, gonna miss that. Have it all the time. My grandmother just fixes it so much, so anything fried.
Everything fried.
Everything fried. You can fry everything.
You really can fry everything. That's a great thing. What extracurricular are you most passionate about? Anything that you got outside of school that you just love?
Well, I'm mostly involved with dance and theater. I do the musical every year, but I can't do straight shows because of dance. It's been really hard to balance those because you can either take theater or you can take choir, and then you can take dance after school. So it's hard balancing all of those things, but I love to do them all. So high school has sort of been hard with trying to pick which one, because I never want to pick.
Why do you think you enjoy theater and dance so much?
It's weird because I hate public speaking more than anything. Like, the senior speech was terrible for me. I just dreaded it so much. And people don't really understand that. You know, you do theater, why do you hate public speaking? But I guess just being able to play someone else, it's not me that I'm playing, or when I'm dancing, it's just weird. It's not like Meggie up there, you know, me as a performer. So I guess I just like that part of it. Ever since I was little, I've just like being on stage and just like singing and acting and dancing. So that's why I love it. And like, if you're in a show, the cast you get so close to, and obviously really close with the dancers. but yeah, that community you get from it, with, I think you can get that with any sport, just being together all the time. And you know, I just love it for many reasons.
What have been some of your favorite memories of high school or just moments?
A lot from fifth grade. Because that's just sort of when our whole grade, we just like started going on this journey. And I remember it was like the beginning of the year when Logan and Day, you were in this class. I brought I had a betta fish. And I was really attached to it, and it died. And so basically fifth grade life skills was just like us all talking about our feelings. And so, I don't, this is really weird, but I brought the fish food in class just to, you know, remember my betta fish, and Logan started eating it. And at the time, look at Logan, because Logan did stuff like that. That was just Logan. But then she started breaking out in hives, and Miss Adams had to call poison control. I don't know.
It was so funny.
Back then it was not funny, but now it's just because that kind of stuff happened all the time in fifth grade.
It did.
So bizarre. But yeah, I have to say most of my memories come from fifth and sixth grade because we're all just so quirky and we still are, but we just didn't know that about each other then, and it was not really accepted yet. So just watching all that stuff come to be was so new, and I still remember so many weird things we all did.
Who have been some influential people in your life up to this point?
Obviously my family, besides my mom, like my grandparents, they live 2 hours away and they're always in town just helping me whatever I need to do, or just being there when I need to talk to someone, or they've just been like second parents. I'd say I'm just as close as I am my parents. And just like, I guess my church has been there for like mentors and stuff. Again, just like people I can come talk to, even teachers here, especially this year. I look up to a lot of my teachers just because you have more freedom to choose classes that you actually want to take. So just people that are really passionate in those areas, it's been really nice to look up to them and ask them about stuff I'm interested in. So yeah, family, mentors, and teachers.
To you personally, what do you think are the most important qualities for somebody to have?
Here? Or
like anywhere in the world, like things that you really respect about people, things that maybe you wish you could be more like, or just, you know, anything like that.
I think here, specifically, and just in general, people that just have a heart for service and are just really driven to do good. Like, as I said, the classes I'm in this year, I've just realized there's so many problems, and just being inspired by people who want to fix them, they're going to do things to fix them. That's what I'm really inspired by and aspire to be, like, really service-driven. And there's a lot of people here like that, so I think that's really admirable.
What are some of your favorite things about Harvest Hall, and what are some things that you might change?
Although hesitant at first, the all-girls thing really worked out. I feel like I would have been a totally different person if I had gone to a co-ed school, even in middle school, because I feel like I've never thought about, you know, raising my hand in the classroom or blabbing or acting weird in class or not wearing makeup to school. And that's something that once we started high school and got all these new people in, I just realized, whoa, I took that so much for granted. But definitely being here is allowing me to sort of figure myself out before I go to college. And there's boys in a room, you know? I feel really confident inside and outside of the classroom. I feel like other people can't define me like that. And that's something I think the biggest thing I've taken away from here. I don't know if you could change this, but I think the school does make an effort to bring in diversity here and make that a big thing and acknowledge that. But I feel like, I know you can't change other people's attitudes, but I feel like we could definitely try to keep more of an open mind and educate ourselves of what else is out there, because sometimes I feel like we're in a bubble, as are most private schools. But I just think that if we tried more and focused on what else is out there, not just what diversity is at Harpeth Hall, because it is limited, but it is there, we just have a more open mind, because there's so much more out there than is here, and I feel like sometimes we try to ignore that.
What are some things that you have been particularly proud of that you've accomplished at Harpeth Hall or otherwise? And is there anything that maybe you would have done differently?
I guess just, it sounds sort of weird, but I've danced since sixth grade here, and just sticking with that through senior years, at times it's been really hard, but it's been really rewarding to say, you know, I've made it for 7 years through this program, and I've been with these same people, and I've been from square one, you know, like looking up to the seniors, and now I am one, and I can have my little family, and like talk to them. I just love, you know, having that. And also the same thing with doing the musical since freshman year. I feel like at senior year, it's the same thing. Like, I've been able to talk to those freshmen. I've just liked growing and then like being the person that I looked up to freshman year. And just having that relationship with the older and younger people has been really rewarding. And something I would have changed. I guess there's a flip side to that, because although it has been really rewarding sticking with dance, I haven't been able to do straight shows, or I haven't been able to do chorus because I did theater. So once again, like being able to choose what you want to do, you can't do it all. And I guess I would have, if I were to go back, I'm not sure, I'd have to decide if I were to do it differently, but I think that I would definitely think about, you know, maybe I want to try this for a while, because now I sort of regret not trying things or not taking like a semester off to do something else, because there are people that do that, and but I have really enjoyed like my consistency. I just wish sometimes I would have had another experience, you know, that was a little different, but I've definitely enjoyed everything I've done here. Sometimes I just wish I could have broadened the horizons, but.
What classes and teachers have like really been important to you over the years here?
Consistently through freshman through senior year, I'd have to say English. I've never been in like AP or honors, but still, like, I've just had some of the most meaningful discussions in the class I think anyone has here are usually in English. Just looking at literature and then comparing to our own lives and having these really cool discussions, I think freshman year, sophomore year, and junior year, and obviously senior year, we've had that. But I think this year, well, last semester, I took Dr. Eckert's World Religions class, and I've always been interested in religion. Like, I go to theology camp. No shame. That sort of made me realize that I want to do it in college, and Dr. Hare is just an encyclopedia, like he knows everything, and that's just really inspiring for me to see him know so much, and just, it's really humbling. I have so much to learn. So that was probably the most influential class I've taken in all of high school.
For you personally, what do you think has been the hardest part about growing up and being a teacher?
Probably socially, just trying to figure out where you're supposed to be. I think in middle school that is the biggest thing, because especially seventh and eighth grade, it's horrible. People are people. but in high school it's weird, because I've never had, all through high school, I've never had a distinct friend group that I've been with all throughout high school. And at times that's been really hard, but I feel like now it's a really big blessing, because I have, you know, people call me like a floater or a drifter, but I feel like it's really good sometimes, because I have friend groups I can just hang out with at different times. You know, I feel like people don't realize that you don't have to limit yourself to one group of people, and I don't know, that's something that's been a struggle, but at the same time it's been really rewarding.
What do you think the high school experience, just in the general sense, has kind of taught you about yourself? What have you really taken away from it?
I feel like senior year has been just so much different than all the other years. Not that I don't know, it's been really weird. I've just realized so many things this year. And I'm sure I obviously learned all the other years too. It's just hit me this year that I'm just really thankful that this school like really makes you wanna learn. It makes you really curious about things that you wanna know about. I feel like that's something that I'll take away with me. That sounds cheesy, but it's really true. Like the classes I'm taking this year and as well as junior year, sophomore year, freshman year. Something in the classes have always got me where I want to learn more about something. And I feel like that's something I've taken away from high school. So if I watch the news or something, I don't understand something, or if I want to know more, I'm going to go look it up because I'm curious and I want to know about it. And I feel like that's really unique to Harvard Hall, and that's just something else I'm really thankful for.
Is there anything else that you would like to add?
Probably advice I give is don't be afraid to ask for help, because especially when I was an underclassman, I was just really proud, felt like I didn't need anyone. Like even academically, if you need help with something, like go see a teacher, it's not a big deal. But especially if you need help with something else, like you can just ask for anything, and everyone at the school is so willing to help you. And I didn't realize that until this year, and I really wish I'd taken advantage of that. So that's just one big thing I wanted to throw out there.